America likes to compare itself to the world a lot, and with the mention in last week's video about how most Americans haven't even left the United States, I thought it would be worth it to take a look at each state in the US and compare them to the rest of the world and see just where they stand on the world stage. Of course, with so many Americans having not left the United States, it can be hard to take the size of other continents in context. I mean, how often has an American planned a European itinerary that looks something like this? Ain't no way you're doing that in 2 weeks. Of course, this could also be helpful for non-Americans looking for a sense of scale for the United States compared to other countries around the world, now that you think about it. With that being said, let's go through a list of every state in the United States and see where each of them compares by area, population, GDP, and GDP per capita to other countries around the world, as dictated by these maps from this cool link. Although the area statistics are from thetruesize.com, also a cool website. Anyway, let's just dive in. Alabama has an area comparable to that of Greece, a population similar to New Zealand, a GDP comparable to that of Czechia, and a GDP per capita of also Czechia. Alaska is similar to Libya in fiscal size, yeah, they are pretty big. Bhutan in population, Bulgaria in GDP, and Switzerland in GDP per capita. Arizona is comparable in size to Italy, really? Okay. In population to Paraguay, GDP and presumably climate to Egypt, and in GDP per capita to, again, also Italy. Yeah, I totally didn't forget to record this the first time. Arkansas can be compared in these metrics that I'm already getting tired of repeating to Greece, again, Armenia, Ukraine, and Czechia. Will we notice a trend of southern states secretly trying to be like Czechia? Eh, probably, but it's more of a weak correlation if you ask me. California will of course soon rule the world, but for now we can compare them to Iraq in both size and presumably climate, Canada, Brazil, and Germany. Kind of weird how Los Angeles and Berlin are basically different planets though. Colorado can be compared pretty easily with New Zealand, Norway, Israel, and Austria. Connecticut with the Bahamas, Uruguay, Chile, and Hong Kong, which isn't actually a real country, but meh, I guess it counts, right? Delaware with Brunei, Fiji, Luxembourg, hey, I've been there, and Switzerland. Yeah, sometimes these little guys can hold a big financial secret. I don't know how much that extends to Delaware, though. Sure, they are a tax haven, but I think their biggest export in recent years has been Salmonella Academy videos. Florida is comparable in these metrics to Suriname, Romania, the Netherlands, and Italy. Georgia has Bangladesh's size, Czechia's population, Norway's GDP, Japan's GDP per capita, and Georgia's name. Hawaii is about the size of Guinea, the equatorial one, has the population of Bahrain, the GDP of Belarus, and the per capita GDP of Denmark. Idaho is comparable to Guyana, Estonia, Luxembourg, and Czechia. Indiana is like Hungary, Paraguay, Singapore, and France, in that... yeah, I got nothing, I just wanted to mix things up a bit more. Illinois is similarly sized, populous, GDP, and GDP per capita to Bangladesh, Belgium, Turkey, and Germany, respectively. Iowa can be compared to Tajikistan, though this is probably the only time you've thought of both these places at once, as well as to Mongolia, in so many ways, Kuwait, and Belgium. Kansas is like Guyana, Albania, Hungary, and Finland, even though it really isn't similar to any of those places at all. Kentucky compares well to Iceland, Croatia, New Zealand, and Spain. Louisiana is best likened to Greece, Ireland, Ireland again, and Australia. Maine has similarities to Portugal, Bahrain, Croatia, and South Korea. Maryland, my birth state statistics, correlate somewhat well with those of Moldova, Nicaragua, South Africa, and Austria. Massachusetts can be easily compared with Haiti, El Salvador, Austria, and Ireland.
Ireland, Europe's Boston.
Michigan is comparable to Guinea, the regular one, Hungary, Austria, and New Zealand. Minnesota is said to go with Guyana, Finland, obviously, Denmark, and the Netherlands. Mississippi correlates with North Korea, well that took a bit of a turn, as well as with Albania, Slovakia, and Portugal. Missouri compares easily to Cambodia, Lebanon, the Philippines, and New Zealand. Montana somehow correlates with Japan, Cyprus, Lithuania, and Spain. Nebraska compares well to Kyrgyzstan, again, have you ever thought of both these places at the same time, and also Latvia, Morocco, and Sweden. Well, that's in GDP per capita, good for them, I guess. Nevada is comparable in size and presumably climate to Burkina Faso, and in nothing else except these predetermined statistics, to Jamaica, Hungary, and Finland. I've heard New Hampshire pairs well with Djibouti, Estonia, Luxembourg, and Iceland. New Jersey shares some select common features with Belize, Austria, Sweden, and Ireland. New Mexico is comparable to Poland, like I said in an old video you probably don't want to see, Slovenia, Ecuador, and Spain. New York in some ways resembles Tajikistan, Chile, South Korea, and Ireland. Fun fact, Irish Americans also make up around 5.3% of New York City's population. North Carolina also seems to pair well in size with Tajikistan, but its other three countries are Portugal, Norway, and the UK, which is where I'll be going next month for FedCon. Okay, back to the education. North Dakota apparently pairs well with Syria, Bhutan, Bulgaria, and Hong Kong, all the while looking like Canada. Ohio compares to Eritrea, Bolivia, Nigeria, and Japan. Oklahoma somehow compares to Cambodia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, whose name is a pain in the ass to type in on Sporkle, Vietnam, and New Zealand. Oregon is just like Ecuador, Panama, Portugal, and the Netherlands. Wait a minute, the Netherlands?
I knew it. Portland is just a hillier version of Amsterdam. Ich wist es.
Pennsylvania is about the same size as Malawi. Well, really? Malawi's as big as Pennsylvania? Well, I guess that puts Southern Africa into context for me. But Pennsylvania can also be compared to Cuba, Switzerland, and the UK. Which is where I'll be going next month for FedCon. Rhode Island is best approximated to Cape Verde, as this guy clearly got right, as well as to Fiji, Uruguay, and Finland. South Carolina compares well to the United Arab Emirates, Costa Rica, Romania, and, again, Czechia. South Dakota is similarly sized to what seems to be its doppelganger, Kyrgyzstan, but also compares to Fiji, Serbia, and Australia. Tennessee equates well to Guatemala, El Salvador, Israel, and Japan. Texas is about the size of Myanmar, but otherwise comparable to Australia, Australia again, and Australia. Utah sizes up well against seemingly every state's favorite analog, Guyana, as well as with Lithuania, Hungary, and France. Well, at least it made a couple more unique picks. Vermont doesn't differ much from Macedonia, Montenegro, Bolivia, and Japan. Virginia seems to pair well with Bulgaria, well, what a coincidence, Israel, Austria, and the Netherlands. Washington correlates well with Syria, Bulgaria, Austria, and the Netherlands. I can't just go refilm the Oregon scene in Seattle, are you serious? Portland and Seattle are not 20 minutes apart. West Virginia is comparable to Latvia, Latvia again, Luxembourg, and Slovenia. Wisconsin doesn't contrast much from Suriname, finally something other than Guyana, Denmark, Hong Kong, and France. Finally, Wyoming compares to Ecuador, Luxembourg, Panama, and Hong Kong. Of course, while this may not teach us all that much, it does put the scale of America's states and some of the small to medium-sized countries of the world into context with each other, which I personally feel is good for the people on both sides of the US's borders. I mean, no European would drive from Sevilla to Moscow, just as any sane American wouldn't drive the similar distance from Washington, D.C. to Portland, Oregon. Well, okay, I actually have driven this once, but I think you get my point. But the size of the other continents isn't always obvious at first, which I think makes this invaluable to planning trips and things like that. Of course, what you do with the other three statistics is anyone's guess. Goodbye. Thank you as always for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please be sure to click the like button, but treat it with respect and dignity, you don't have to go too hard on it, and also share it with anyone else who might be interested in this crap. And also, thank you all for 30,000 subscribers. To celebrate, I will of course be doing another live stream. Be sure to see the latest community tab post for more details. And either way, I will see you with a regular video on Sunday.